What's going on, everyone? 2022 proved to be a pretty solid year for movies, and 2023 looks like it's going to be even better. Today, I am ranking the top 10 most anticipated movies of 2023. Let me know down in the comments which movie you're most looking forward to this year. If you haven't yet, subscribe to today's rankings and leave a like on this video. The next year is going to provide some fantastic films, so without further ado, let's get into it. Number 10, Indiana Jones and the Dial of Destiny. It's safe to say I'm more than a little bit hesitant to throw this one on the list, seeing as 2008's Indiana Jones and the Kingdom of the Crystal Skull was the weakest entry in the franchise. I am, however, way too much of a sucker for a Harrison Ford film to not go see this movie when it comes out. Early rumors suggest that time travel may potentially be involved with the film, which I hope isn't the case. Time travel plots far more often than not tend to make for a poor movie with too many plot holes. I'm not exactly sure why we really need another Indiana Jones movie. This seems more like Harrison Ford wanting one final send-off with the opportunity to re-don the iconic hat and whip one last time. Mads Mikkelsen in the role of the villain will hopefully help prop this film up a bit, but it may take more than a great supporting performance to make a good film. Will it be entertaining? Absolutely. Will it be good? That remains to be seen. Indiana Jones and the Dial of Destiny releases on June 30th. Number 9, Scream 6. Horror films rank pretty high up there as one of my favorite movie genres. The Scream franchise, while it may feel tiresome to some, is one that I'm always up for and eager to see when the newest rendition releases. Scream 6 is no exception, and it has a lot of things going for it. For one, along with the previous Scream film in 2022, it feels like a fresh start for the franchise, having more than likely bid an official farewell to longtime franchise lead actors David Arquette and Neve Campbell, with rising superstar Jenna Ortega from the popular Netflix series Wednesday and her on-screen sister Melissa Barrera returning to lead the Scream franchise into the future. The film will still, however, showcase a few longtime members of the franchise, including the likes of Courtney Cox and Hayden Panettiere. Not much else is known about the film other than that the setting won't be in the traditional Woodsboro, but rather in New York City, and the iconic Ghostface mask is looking a little bit weathered in this iteration. I love a good whodunit movie, which is why I also think Scream stands the test of time compared to some other horror movie franchises. Scream 6 is scheduled to come out on March 10th. Number 8, John Wick 4. Can you name me another movie franchise where each movie continues to get better and better with every film? It's a rarity that's few and far between these days, and John Wick has found its footing as the quintessential action thriller of our time, sporting rising Rotten Tomatoes scores with every subsequent entry of the franchise from both critics and audience members alike. John Wick movies never disappoint, with a dazzling mix of gunplay and beautifully choreographed fight scenes. Keanu Reeves continues to be everyone's favorite anti-hero, as he ages gracefully like a fine wine. You know what you're getting when you walk into a John Wick movie, yet you always leave feeling like you've just watched one of your favorite action films in a long time. Honestly, I would be shocked if they stopped with John Wick 4. The John Wick franchise has almost developed a cult-like following to it, and they'll likely continue creating John Wick films as long as they can. John Wick 4 releases on March 23rd. Number 7, Ant-Man and the Wasp, Quantumania. I am actually terrified that this movie isn't going to be good. Sure, I'm really excited for it, but I am far more nervous that this will be a giant swing and a miss. Quantumania is arguably the most important Marvel film since Endgame, seeing as it is the beginning of the Marvel Cinematic Universe's Phase 5. Perhaps more importantly, the villain of this film is none other than Kang the Conqueror, who is slated to be the next Thanos, if you will, of Phases 5 and 6, with the next two Avengers films, The Kang Dynasty and Secret Wars, both being slated to be released 6 months apart in 2025. Personally, I always found Ant-Man to be the most underrated Marvel franchise. I absolutely love Paul Rudd in the role and the perfect blend of seriousness and humor that he brings to it. However, we'll likely see a pretty big shift towards a more serious tone with Quantumania, seeing as this will have a rippling effect for the rest of the MCU upcoming releases. For that reason, the film will likely not end on a happy note, but rather one that forces the heroes of the film and the MCU as a whole to begin the process of assembling to defeat Kang the Conqueror. Ant-Man and the Wasp: Quantumania is slated to debut on February 17th. Number 6, Spider-Man: Across the Spider-Verse, the first of two animated movies on this list. Across the Spider-Verse, the sequel to 2018's Into the Spider-Verse, has our hero Miles Morales returning as everyone's favorite web-slinger. Along with the likes of Gwen Stacy and Peter Parker returning for roles in the movie, we will also get to see the Spider-Man from the future featured in the after-credit scene of Into the Spider-Verse, Miguel O'Hara, played by Oscar Isaac. These likely won't be the only Spider-Heroes we see in the film as we continue to explore the Spider-Verse. Into the Spider-Verse was renowned for its specific style of animation, using line art over 3D models and applying shaded tones to create a vibrant, comic book-like appearance. In addition to this style of animation, Across the Spider-Verse will reportedly showcase 6 different animation styles, which would lead us to believe we'll likely be visiting at least 6 different worlds in the film. This movie is almost guaranteed to be nominated for Best Animated Feature at the Oscars, and I wouldn't be shocked if it ends up taking home the award just like its predecessor did back in 2018. Spider-Man Across the Spider-Verse releases June 2nd. Number 5, The Super Mario Bros. Movie. Here's a bit of a controversial one, as there are many people already rooting for this movie's downfall. But when I tell you I'm genuinely excited about the Super Mario Bros. Movie, I can't express this enough. Having a huge part of your childhood taken and developed into a film is one of the greatest feelings. Everyone loves a good healthy dose of nostalgia. Say what you want about some of the voice casting, but I honestly don't think it's that bad. Okay, maybe that's a little generous, but in all seriousness, the cast for this movie is stacked with some of comedy's funniest personalities, including Jack Black, Keegan-Michael Key, Fred Armisen, and Seth Rogen, just to name a few. Similar to Across the Spider-Verse, I'd also be a bit surprised if this movie isn't nominated at next year's Oscars for Best Animated Feature as well.
No pressure.
Everyone's favorite plumber will hit the big screens on April 7th. Number 4, Killers of the Flower Moon. These next 4 films are undoubtedly the 4 that I'm most excited for this year. Of all the movies on this list, Killers of the Flower Moon is probably the one with the least certainty surrounding its release. It was initially scheduled for a 2022 release after wrapping its filming in 2021, but was later pushed back to 2023. The movie stars Leonardo DiCaprio in its leading role and is directed by the incredible Martin Scorsese. Killers of the Flower Moon is based upon the book by the same title, covering the true story during the 1920s of the discovery of oil beneath the land of the Osage people. After the Osage people were awarded the rights to the oil profits, members of the lucrative oil business began to lose vast amounts of money. Meanwhile, entire communities began to develop plans to kill and rob the oil wealth of the Osage people. There's certainly something to be said about a well-written work of nonfiction, especially a crime drama, that sheds light upon an awful series of malicious deeds and the cover-up behind all of it. If the film is anywhere as good as the novel by David Gran, then Killers of the Flower Moon will make a killing at the box office, no pun intended. It is currently speculated to release sometime in May, although it still has yet to pin down an official release date. Number 3, Bo is Afraid. Similar to Killers of the Flower Moon, there are also a lot of unknowns surrounding Bo is Afraid. Let's start with the film's name. It may sound unfamiliar to you because up until 3 weeks ago, the movie was operating under the working title Disappointment Boulevard. Additionally, many efforts have been made to keep details of the film under wraps. Bo is Afraid was written, directed, and produced by one of my personal favorite directors, Ari Aster, known for his visually stirring, unorthodox, yet astounding films of the psychological horror genre, which includes the likes of 2018's Hereditary and 2019's Midsommar. More details regarding the film's plot should be on the near horizon. The movie is described as an intimate, decade-spanning portrait of one of the most successful entrepreneurs of all time. The supernatural and psychologically surreal have a tendency to envelop Aster's films, and I have little reason to believe Bo is Afraid will be any different. If you never had the opportunity to watch Hereditary or Midsommar, I highly recommend watching both of those to get a sense of Aster's unique style of storytelling. I will certainly be seeing this one on opening night, and it is currently scheduled to make its debut on April 28th. Number 2, Dune, Part 2. The first Dune film was arguably my favorite movie of 2021, and if you still haven't seen it, imagine Star Wars meets Blade Runner with some extra spice thrown in there. That joke definitely went over your head if you haven't seen the movie. Like the first film, Dune Part 2 is an adaptation of Frank Herbert's 1965 novel of the same name. The movie will pick back up where the first film left off, roughly halfway through the story from the massive novel, with Paul Atreides out for revenge against those who attacked his family. Sporting an all-star cast, including the likes of Timothée Chalamet and Zendaya, the movie will also bring on newcomers Florence Pugh, Austin Butler, and even Christopher Walken to round out the star-studded list of talented actors. Dune is a perfect example of the type of universe that we as moviegoers love to get lost in. It's the perfect combination of sci-fi, adventure, and fantasy that makes for a truly enjoyable experience. This film also has incredible importance when it comes to the Dune franchise as a whole. There are 14, yes, 14 Dune novels in total, potentially providing endless amounts of source content for years to come. If the decision is made to continue with many more iterations of Dune films, the Dune cinematic universe arguably has the potential to rank among those of the all-time great sci-fi franchises when it's all said and done. I'm still kicking myself that I haven't read Herbert's masterpiece. However, I fully intend to read Dune prior to the release of Part 2, which premieres on November 3rd. Before we get to the number one movie I'm most excited about, remember to hit that subscribe button so you don't miss a Today's Rankings video. Just like the channel's next video ranking the top 10 Batman villains. Here's a few more honorable mentions that I'm also excited for this year that didn't quite make the list. Oppenheimer. Last but not least, we have a film that many, including myself, have been eagerly anticipating for a couple years now. Oppenheimer will be Christopher Nolan's first movie since 2020's Tenet, a film that perhaps unfairly didn't get its due recognition as it premiered during the COVID-19 pandemic. Christopher Nolan is a cinematic genius, and I truly believe he belongs in the discussion of one of the greatest directors of all time. While many of Nolan's films have a tendency to focus on the idea of time, Oppenheimer will likely be much more similar to 2017's Dunkirk, which aims to shed light on a historically significant moment. For those that may not know, J. Robert Oppenheimer is credited with the invention of the atomic bomb, something the film will obviously explore in much more depth and likely detail the emotional toll that came along with the responsibility of its creation. Notably, Oppenheimer will feature Cillian Murphy as Robert J. Oppenheimer, who has worked with Nolan several times during the Batman films, Inception, and Dunkirk. On a personal note, Murphy is one of my top two or three favorite actors, and my favorite actress Florence Pugh will also be starring in the film alongside the likes of Robert Downey Jr., Matt Damon, Emily Blunt, and many other incredible actors. This may be a way too early prediction, but if this film lives up to all the hype, it's likely Cillian Murphy taking home an Oscar for Best Actor next year. Oppenheimer hits theaters on July 21st and will likely be another example of a spectacular Nolan film with breathtaking intensity and awe-striking grandeur that keeps audiences coming back every time. Check out the videos on screen. Thanks for watching this video. Remember to subscribe and hit that bell to know when the next Today's Rankings video goes live. Leave it a like and comment down below. What do you want to see ranked next? This has been Ben for Today's Rankings. Have a great day.